Friends, in today's video, we are going to see the top-down program for CoinChange problem. In my last video, I have already explained the recursive program and did a dry run for it to find out that whether we can apply dynamic programming here or not. And our conclusion was that we can apply dynamic programming here. And if you have not watched those videos, then please go and watch those videos before watching this one. Otherwise, you will find it very difficult to understand. I have shared that particular video in my description as well as the I button. Now you can see here, this is my recursive code and this is the recursion tree. You may be thinking why I have written this. So first of all, I am going to change this recursive program and going to convert it to a top-down program. And this particular recursion tree is going to help us in finding the table dimension. That is, whether it is a 1D table. That is, the memo table will be a 1D table or 2D table. And second thing, it is going to help us to find the size of table. So let's do the first thing first, that is table dimension. And one more thing, I have drawn this particular recursion tree for this example, that is coin denomination I have available is 1, 2, 3 and amount I have is 5. That is, what is the minimum number of coin I need for amount equal to 5 given I have this coin denomination? Got it? So this is my recursion tree and now let's find the table dimension. See, I have only one variable here, that is V. And what is V here? Amount. And it is the only thing which is varying. So my table dimension will be 1, that is, it will be a 1D list as we are using Python to code. And second thing is that, what is the size of table? See, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. How many unique values are taken here? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2. But one thing, do we know the answer of minus 1, minus 2, minus 3? Yes, we know, and it is minus infinity. Sorry, it is infinity. And for every negative value, my answer is infinity. So basically, how many unique things I have here? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So what I want to say here is that if the amount is n, then my table dimension will be n plus 1. This is my second thing, that is size of the table. That is, if amount is n, my table size will be n plus 1. And one more thing, now we have table dimension and size of the table. What do we need? We need an identifier. Why? Because we are going to check in my memo table that whether we have calculated that value earlier or not. So, what will be my identifier here? Minus 1. Why? Because min coin cannot be minus 1. So, what I am going to do now? I am going to create a memo table and going to initialize it with minus 1. So, coin earn is going to be my memo table. This is my initialization and this is my size. This is my identifier, or you can say value with which I am initializing my memo table. So my table is ready. What is my next task? I am going to edit this particular code and will make it a top-down code. And to do that, what we are going to do? Wherever we are returning a value, we are going to first save in my memo table and then return. So coin R of V is equal to min coin. We have saved it in my array and after that we will return it. Coin R of V. This is one thing. And the second thing I am returning is returning 0 when V is equal to 0. That is, when my amount is equal to 0, we are returning 0. But if you want, you can ignore this particular thing, because it is not going to have any impact on my code. See, Now and return thing is done. What we need to do next? We need to check whether we have calculated this value prior or not. And to do that, what we need to do? We need to check in my memo table. If coin R of V is not equal to -1, that means I have updated my memo table and I am going to return coin R of V from my table. So this is all we need to update in the recursive code to make it a top-down code. Only two line change. So this is my top-down code now. And if you will execute this particular code on this example, then how will my recursion tree look like? See, this is my coin R memo table. This is my memo table 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. See, this is my recursion tree 1, 0. So, as you can see here, 1 is returning. So, before returning, what I am going to do is I will update it here. And let's you be denoting that I have updated this particular cell. Now as you can see here, after that 2 will return. Again I am updating it to you, that is I am making a change for us to know that I have updated this particular value. And after that what I will do? See, again this 2 will return something to 3. And 3 will call again 1. And first of all, what it will do? It will check whether I have updated this particular value in my table or not. And as you can see here, it is U. That means I have updated this value. So basically, this particular tree is not going to grow. And what we will do next? We are going to delete it. That is, in my top-down table, this particular tree will not grow. And this will return, and 3 will return. After that, 3 will return it answer to 4, and 4 will call 2 again. And first of all, what it will do? It will check in the memo table whether I have updated it or not. And as you can see here, 2 is updated. So basically, what will happen? It will directly take its value from the memo table, and this function call will not be made. Got it? And then 2 will return it answer to 4, and 4 will again call 1. And as you can see here, we have already updated it here, so this function call will not be made, and 1 will return its on answer to 4. So 4 will be updated here, and after that what will happen? 4 will return its answer to 5, and 5 is going to call 3. And we are going to check it using this line. We will check in my memo table whether we have calculated it or not. And as you can see here, it is updated. So this whole tree will not grow, and we will directly take our value from the memo table, and we will return this particular value to C of 5. Then again C of 5, what it will do? It will call C of 2. And here you can see it is updated. So basically, it will return its value from here, and this whole tree will not grow. And then C of 5 will return the actual answer. And prior to that, it is going to update it. So as you can see here, this is my top-down tree. See the difference between the recursion tree and a top-down tree.